90-minute time limit with the heavyweight championship on the line. Currently in the ring, referee Rudy Charles to oversee this contest. Jim Fannin has the stopwatch in the ring for a reason. The last time these two hooked up, they went to a 60-minute draw on December the 21st, 2002, right here at Clarksville, Indiana. They went 55 minutes 1 year ago this weekend in a historic tables and ladders match in Charlestown, Indiana, at the last show at the House of Hardcore, which saw CM Punk retain the heavyweight championship, grabbing the heavyweight title out of the rafters in a match that many people called the 2002 match of the year, not just here in the IWA, but in professional wrestling as a whole. Right now in the ring, Dory Funk Jr., Les Thatcher, Ian Rotten, Fit Finley, Dave Taylor, William Regal, Trey Knee, Chris Hero. He's got a lot of influences, and it shows in his wrestling style each and every time he steps foot in the ring. But the man that he stands across the ring from tonight is a man that he stood across this ring from on many, many occasions. But a man that he has only been able to pin 1, 2, 3 in an IWA ring one time in his career. And that was the very first time that they hooked up in an IWA ring as part of a six-man elimination tag team match in January 2001. There you have him, your heavyweight champion, CM Punk. Knows that he's got his hands full. 2 out of 3 falls tonight, February the 7th, 2003. The influences of this man are manyfold as well. Studies videotapes from all over the world, Mexico, Japan, the United States. Trained by Ace Steel and Danny Dominion with a little bit of assistance from world travelers such as Adam Pearce, Kevin Quinn. Training partner of Classic Colt Cabana and several others who embrace the IWA Midsouth ring. Has learned from the likes of Rey Mysterio Jr., Eddie Guerrero, Jerry Lynn, Tracy Smothers, and countless veterans of the IWA. Jim Fannin set the table for our heavyweight championship contest.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the match you've all been waiting for. 2 out of 3 falls, 90-minute time limit for the IWA Mid-South World Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, he comes into this matchup as the challenger. He is a former two-time IWA Mid-South Heavyweight Champion from Metropolis, weighing at 240 pounds, Chris Hero! And his opponent, he is your current IWA Mid-South World Heavyweight Champion from Chicago, Illinois, CM Punk!
Hero has constantly chased CM Punk for that heavyweight championship ever since it was first held by Chris Hero. He dropped that title to CM Punk himself after capturing it from the rugby thug, Trent Baker. Chris Hero has never been able to win the heavyweight championship from CM Punk in any of their matches. Jim Fannin, this has the makings of a true mat classic, not only here in the IWA, but anywhere in the wrestling world. The stopwatch is running. Rudy Charles, head referee of the NWA TNA, now one of the IWA regular officials, will be officiating this contest. as right off the bat, Chris Hero with the early advantage, trying to trap the hands of CM Punk while putting weight down onto the back.
Well, Dave Prazak, I don't think anybody here in this building tonight can argue with the fact that, hands down, this is quite possibly the best series of matchups that has ever graced an IWA ring. These men know each other so well. They've battled up and down the road all across this country. They made their names here in the IWA Mid-South, and they carried it all around the country with this, I won't call it a feud, because right now there's no hatred amongst these two. It's all respect. It's a rivalry. Who's the best?
It's about athleticism, and I mean, it hasn't always been a friendly rivalry. It hasn't always been about what Chris Hero and CM Punk said on the microphone after their one-hour draw back in late December 2002, where they said, hey, we like to come out here every once in a while and wrestle each other and beat each other to oblivion every once in a while for upwards of 45 minutes. We like doing this to each other because, hey, it's competition. We want to know who the better man is. And on any given night, either one of these two guys could score a pinfall victory. Tonight, 2 out of 3 falls. You got to beat the guy twice.
Well, I don't know if I would go quite that far, Dave Prazak, as we have studied up on this coming into this matchup. Not either one of these men can gain a pinfall over the other. Chris Hero has had very poor luck in this series of matches with CM Punk. He only holds one pinfall victory, and that was in a tag matchup here in an IWA Mid-South ring.
And that was back in their first meeting. It was January 6, 2001, an IWA Odyssey. It was a six-man tag, The Resistance, of which Chris Hero was a part, along with tag team partners Mark Wolf and Todd Morton, Michael Todd Stratton, to take on the Gold Bond Mafia that night of CM Punk, Paul E. Smooth, Chucky Smooth, and Classic Colt Cabana. It was an elimination match, and Hero was able to pin CM Punk and eliminate him from that matchup, but he has never pinned CM Punk in a singles contest in the IWA ever, and his only pinfall victory was in that elimination match. But, I mean, one thing that does have to be brought up is that the IWA isn't the only place that these two have wrestled each other. I mean, they've brought this feud around the world, and there are other parts of the country, other promotions, that Chris Hero has had a little bit better luck against CM Punk. But what counts right now is that IWA Heavyweight Championship belt. What counts is what happens in this ring. And in this ring, Chris Hero needs to prove himself as an adversary of CM Punk.
That he does. As both of these men will tell you, they step it up a notch when they're here in the IWA Mid-South. You know, they wrestled at a show in Indianapolis with 8 people at it. You know, when they come here, the crowd treats them with respect. They know that the fans are here to see them. They want to see what they can do, just how great these two have gotten going against each other, going against other greats in this business. I mean, they've wrestled the Jerry Lynns. They've wrestled the Eddie Guerreros, the Rey Mysterio Juniors. And this is our pride and joy right here, Dave Prazak. I hope this matchup goes 90 minutes. I hope it goes all night long.
Well, so do I. And I mean, I think a lot of the fans expect that this match is going to go very long. You can tell they're starting this thing off very slow-paced, a lot of mat wrestling, exchanging holds down on the mat. They know that if they make one early error trying to go fast-paced right off the bat, it could cost them a fall, and it could cost them a victory in this matchup. I mean, this is the one-year anniversary of what's quite possibly the most talked about match in IWA history, the tables and ladders match
actually,
a year ago this weekend.
Tomorrow night is the one-year anniversary. CM Punk booked for Ring of Honor tomorrow night. Therefore, the matchup takes place tonight. But this is the exactly one-year anniversary of the gauntlet matchup.
Tonight's the one-year anniversary of the
5 minutes are gone. 5 minutes.
Tomorrow night's the one-year anniversary of the
tables, ladders, and chairs.
Actually, the gauntlet match. Tonight's the 7th, right?
Yes.
Okay.
The gauntlet matchup,
gauntlet
45
was the
minutes.
8th, and the 9th was the tables and ladders. So we're actually 2 days away from the actual anniversary of the
however it worked out.
Gauntlet is a year ago tomorrow. But the point is, these guys have brought their feud all over the country, and tonight, once again, in the IWA ring, we know that this thing is going to take a while because it is 2 out of 3 falls.
Although, with in a the quick schoolboy right there, CM Punk almost gave
in the last time these men met, as we've already mentioned, 60-minute time limit draw with no pinfall.
It seems that almost every time that these guys step in the ring with one another, the match goes a little bit longer because they know each other just that much more. First time they wrestled each other in the IWA singles went about 20, 25 minutes. After that, it was about 25 minutes in Indianapolis when CM Punk first captured the IWA Heavyweight Championship from Chris Hero in December of the year 2001. They followed that up with the first 2 out of 3 falls match and the only 2 out of 3 falls match other than this one that these two have had.
And Chris Hero did win a fall in that matchup, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, he
didn't
win the match.
He didn't win the match. So he has 2 pinfalls, I guess, over CM Punk in an IWA ring, but
that match,
only one really counts.
That match wound up going a little bit longer. That went about a half hour. And of course, you had the gauntlet match the night before the tables and ladders match where
45 minutes.
CM Punk wrestled for 45 minutes, the last 15 of which was against Chris Hero. And then they went 55 in the tables and ladders match.
I hate to keep cutting you off, but who knows how long they'd have went in a gauntlet match had the time not expired.
Had the time not expired.
CM Punk had to defeat Sexy A Steel, classic Colt Cabana. Only left 15 minutes in that matchup when Chris Hero came out. They could still be wrestling today had that time limit not run out on them.
That's true.
And as I had said last week, that weekend, CM Punk wrestled 45 minutes in the gauntlet, 55 minutes in the tables, ladders, and chairs, 110 minutes in one weekend. And as I told the people who bought Smart Mark video of last week to watch Chris Hero versus Jerry Lynn, as I said then, you have to watch Raw and SmackDown, both shows, for like two and a half, 3 months in order to get 110 minutes of wrestling.
Actual wrestling. And that's something that not only IWA Mid-South Hardcore Wrestling, but independent wrestling in general can provide to you, the wrestling fan, that you might not be able to get from the WWE. It's a throwback to the old days, you might say. I mean, how many times do you see 2 out of 3 falls matches, much less 90-minute time limits in the World Wrestling Entertainment Organization? I mean, at independent shows, you get to see more of the athletic side of professional wrestling. You get to see more of a contest. You get to see guys go the distance. And you see that quite often from these two, and tonight should be no different, Jim.
Dave Prazak, you know my opinion of other independent organizations around the country. But I'll tell you this, if you're watching this on home video, we're out in the middle of nowhere here in southern Indiana. But if you ever see a card that is within driving distance that has the matchup Chris Hero versus CM Punk, whether it's a 3-hour drive, whether it's a 4-hour drive, if you're not doing anything that day, whether the rest of the matchups on the card is broomstick versus mop bucket, go to that show, because the drive and all the crappy wrestling that you have to sit through would be made up for with this matchup. And I tell you, since Ian Rotten announced that we were going to do a 1-year anniversary of this matchup, I've been looking forward to this.
And the fans have been looking forward to it ever since the last time these two hooked up and they went to a draw. And now, again, they're trading a lot of holds down on the mat right now, just trying to get an advantage early on. I mean, we're nowhere near either man being weakened enough at this point in order to gain a pinfall victory just yet. And you know that neither one's going to give it up that fast.
And there's too much pride at stake here. You're going to have to rip somebody's limb off to get them to say, I quit in this matchup. There's too much at stake. Who is the best young lion in independent wrestling? These two are fighting it out here tonight, and neither one of them is going to say the words, I quit.
10 minutes are gone. 10 minutes.
Now, the background of Chris Hero it reads like a book. I mean, you could say that when CM Punk comes out to the ring that he was trained by Ace Steel and Danny Dominion. They were the main two guys that taught CM Punk the ins and outs of professional wrestling, along with some of the other students and assistant trainers at the Steel Domain Training Center in Chicago, Illinois, while it was still open, such as the wild child Kevin Quinn, who spent a lot of time down in Puerto Rico and in Mexico and along with Scrap Iron Adam Pearce, who has since relocated to California. But he also, you know, has wrestled a lot with the likes of the guys in the IWA that I mentioned that he had the experience of wrestling against, thanks to wrestling in the IWA. People like Rey Mysterio Jr., Eddie Guerrero, not only in the IWA, but in the IWC out in Pittsburgh. CM Punk was able to learn a little bit from each of those guys that he stepped in the ring with to better himself as an athlete. And he has just about as many influences Chris Hero does, even though the list of wrestling schools that he's attended only lists one as the Steel Domain out of Chicago, Illinois.
Well, here's the big thing about these two individuals, Dave Prazak. And you know, you've been around the independent scene longer and been to way more places than I could ever dream of being. The attitude of independent wrestlers sometimes is a little bit shaky. They figure that they're in the ring, they know everything, they have nothing else to learn. You can't teach them anything, they don't want to get better. These two will sit and they'll watch a matchup between Richard X and Isaiah to learn just a little bit more. Maybe they can pick up another move that they haven't quite perfected yet that somebody else has done, and then they can add it to their repertoire, make themselves just a little bit better. Because as we both know, the day you stop learning and stop trying to learn is the day you might as well get out of the ring, because you're of no use to the wrestling business anymore.
Quick escape by CM Punk. Went right through the legs of Chris Hero and ducked his head between the top and the middle rope to take a little bit of a break, shake out his arm a little bit as Hero was going to work on it. Again, neither man with so much of an advantage thus far that we can say the match is in anyone's favor just yet. But besides the fact of at a wrestling show that they might be on, watching the other matches and trying to pick up a little bit from the other guys on the card, and wrestling people like Jerry Lynn and Tracy Smothers and listening to them just give advice in the locker room. You know, what do you think that I did right? What do you think I did wrong? After they came back from having their match that night and taking in their advice into account. You also got to know, Chris Hero has one of the most extensive videotape collections of anyone that I know, wrestling fan, wrestler, video distributor or anything. And you know, CM Punk's and Ace Steel's videotape collection almost mirrors that of Chris Hero. They study tapes from Japan, Mexico, all over the United States. They study old Johnny Saint tapes to try to pick up a little bit different counters to things. They're always students of the game, and that is why they can exchange holds for upwards of 45, 55, 60 minutes and not even gain a pinfall victory over their opponent, because they know each other like a book.
Well, I can speak from experience here with Chris Hero. If that man didn't have to sleep, if he wasn't wrestling on a show, he'd be watching tapes 24 hours a day. The kid just cannot get enough of wrestling. It's all he wants to do in his life. And I gotta say, he's quite successful at what he has chosen to do.
Punk trying to hold on to this headlock on Chris Hero. A couple shots in the midsection of Punk, goes for the shoulder block. Hero does not go down. Punk hits the rope, slides through the legs of Chris Hero. Arm drag, takes the big man over, holds onto the arm, barring the arm now, and putting the weight of his knee onto the side of the head of Chris Hero.
You know, CM Punk has a tremendous advantage in this contest, Dave Prazak. He's got the psychological advantage, knowing that every time that the chips are down, he was able to pull out a victory over Chris Hero. He also knows that this thing can go 60 minutes before we even get one fall.
And so he's got the title around his waist. As Bobby Heenan always said, he's got to beat you, you don't have to beat him.
Exactly.
I mean, if this thing goes to the 90-minute time limit, CM Punk walks out of this building just like he walked in, with a heavyweight title around his waist.
We are almost 15 minutes in, and these men are just going hold for hold, Dave Prazak.
No decided advantage just yet. There's one-handed Greco-Roman knuckle lock held by CM Punk right now. Lifts up the entire body of Chris Hero, now putting the weight of his leg down onto the arm of Hero.
And even though Chris Hero's lost some weight, he's still 240 thick pounds. That is a lot of weight to be picking up off the ground like
and
that.
We have also seen, don't let Chris Hero's appearance fool you. Some of you who might not have seen too much of Chris Hero and his wrestling style in some of his previous matches, He might not be the most muscular guy in the world. He might have a little bit of extra weight on him, but that does not cut his wind back one bit. I mean, how long was his match with Cash Flow?
They went 60 minutes.
They went 60 minutes. He's gone the distance with CM Punk on several occasions. Chris Hero is not about to get winded in that ring from just having to go at it for a long period of time against his opponent. He can hang in there, and for a guy his size, can keep up with a fast-paced light heavyweight wrestler like a CM Punk, like a Suicide Kid back in the day when they had their feud, like the American Kickboxer, who had a tremendous series of matches with Chris Hero, culminating in a tables and ladders match at April Blood Showers 2001. Chris Hero is no stranger to fast-paced athletic wrestling, and he can fly given his size.
Oh, given anyone's size, this man can fly with the cruiserweights any day of the week. You know, and I get sickened every time I get on the internet and someone tells me that Chris Hero doesn't look like a wrestler. Those steroid freaks in WWE, they look like wrestlers, and they couldn't carry a match for 3 minutes if they had to. You know, give me a Chris Hero any day of the week over someone that other people may think looks like a wrestler. I want someone who wants to come out here and be the best wrestler he can be, wants to leave it all on the line each and every time, and doesn't care whether there's 10 people in the crowd, whether there's 10,000, he's gonna give it all, and he's not gonna leave an ounce of energy in his body once that match is done.
Hero Monkey flips CM Punk, who holds onto the Greco-Roman knuckle lock, and Hero rolled back with it, and they still are jockeying for leverage at this point. Hero with the advantage, over top of CM Punk. Right?
As we near the 20-minute mark here, Dave Prazak, we did a very unique thing before this matchup. We went around and grabbed some people's predictions.
Yes,
we have some predictions.
And first, we know all over the internet, people are making predictions. How long is this thing going to go? Because they know that
I hear there's like 4 or 5 pages of bets on the CZW fan board. How long will this thing go? We went around and asked some people. We've got
in the locker room and otherwise, some of the right now inside the ring, they're just exchanging slaps right now. I don't know, trying to anger each other and get a little bit of fire going. Yeah, they've been exchanging holds for a while, but see some aggression coming out right about now, 20 minutes deep.
Let's look at a couple of predictions from the fans. We went around and got a couple of fans' predictions. Home Depot Mike, who posts on the message board all the time as Rotten Rules, he predicts that Chris Hero will finally climb that mountain and get the long-anticipated victory over CM Punk here tonight in 85 minutes.
85 minutes. Well, if these guys, I have no doubt that they can go 85 minutes if that's what it comes down to. And it might take that long for Chris Hero to finally score 2 pinfall victories against CM Punk in the same match and walk out with that heavyweight title around his waist.
And in another fan prediction, Ian Rotten's number one fan, Phyllis, predicts that CM Punk will continue his dominance over Chris Hero by winning the matchup tonight in 87 minutes.
87 minutes. Okay, we'll up that a little bit more. Shotgun Yan all the way out of Chicago picks Chris Hero, and he says that the match is going to go 90 minutes.
He told me that Hero would get the pinfall in the final second.
In the final second of the match?
Because Hero had the hangman's clutch in the 60-minute draw. He had CM Punk. All he had to do was just have a few more seconds. Punk was ready to tap out, but time ran out. Tonight, Jan thinks that Hero will get that move on just a little bit earlier. Hit the Hero's welcome, whatever it takes. He thinks he's going to get it in the final seconds.
And speaking of the hangman's clutch, there's a modification of it as he's got the cravat, the three-quarter chancery around the head of CM Punk, wearing down the neck and putting pressure on the head as well, while still keeping CM Punk right down on the mat as the fans are appreciative of the back-and-forth action that they're witnessing in the ring right now. We have Big Daddy Vic Von Erich, who predicted 88-minute match, says Big Daddy Vic.
But he didn't predict a winner.
But he didn't predict a winner. He just knew they were going to go 88 minutes.
We had a lot of that with the guy. I mean,
they can't pick a winner?
We were asking the wrestlers in the back before this matchup started. A lot of them hemmed and hawed and went back and forth, not really knowing which way that this matchup could go. I mean, we pretty much got an answer out of everybody.
Well, we saw them pull this thing off at the Ted Petty Invitational. Yeah, they look like frogs right now, headstands. Trying to see who could get the leverage right there. And again, we're at a stalemate.
That'll kill the hamstrings.
Yeah.
And in a move like that, when you're potentially going 90 minutes, a move like that will kill you in the later going.
And we don't even have a one-fall advantage for either wrestler at this point. As referee Rudy Charles says, these guys need to lock up.
We have another fan prediction.
Paula?
The lovely Paula
from the concession stand. What does she say, Jim?
She picks CM Punk. She picks CM Punk. She loves CM Punk. And the time, 69-69.
69 minutes, 69. I think Paula needs to go back to selling nachos, bitch, and stop worrying about CM Punk going 69 minutes and 69 seconds. You know, Jim, that's actually 70 minutes and change.
Yes, it is.
Brutal forearms across the back of CM Punk by Chris Hero. And for the first time, we really see a decided advantage right now as CM Punk bails out to the floor to catch his breath and sort of regain his bearings a little bit. Now he's back up on the apron, climbing back into the ring. And Chris Hero showing a little bit more aggression so far. I mean, we saw them exchanging holds, trying to go for leverage early on in the first chunk of this match, but right now it looks like Chris Hero's taking the initiative and starting to throw some hard-hitting blows inside the squared circle.
Well, you know, we said earlier that this matchup right now is based out of respect. It's a rivalry for who's the better man. But as you had said then, that's not always been the case. You know, maybe there's still some pent-up frustration inside Chris Hero, and maybe that's why he's getting aggressive right now. Or perhaps it's just the fact that he knows that the tables, ladders, and chairs matchup was his last chance at CM Punk. It was his last title shot against CM Punk. And of course, CM Punk has since lost and regained that title a couple of different times.
There's a beautiful headstand by Chris Hero. Maneuvering his way out of the arm bar that CM Punk had applied after arm dragging Chris Hero and holding onto the arm.
How's that for agility and stamina from the big man? You know, Chris Hero, about 6'6", 240 pounds. He's been in the gym lately. He's peeled off a lot of weight. And he's still, what, maybe 22, 23 years old?
I believe he's about 22. Yep.
I mean, he's still very young. And look at how far, I mean, he came to IWA as a young little kid. If you have videotapes from back then, you won't even be able to really, you won't even really be able to recognize him. He's come so far in such a short period of time, not quite 3 years with us.
Jim, all of the young crew of scientific wrestlers that have come into the IWA and broke out of the pack as superstars in the past year or two, came to the IWA as relatively inexperienced wrestlers. Right now, CM Punk hitting the ropes, trying to go through the legs of Chris Hero, but he holds onto the waist lock before Punk can make it through his legs and back behind him, and once again, jockeying for position. But all in the summer of 2000, the CM Punks, the Chris Heroes, the Colt Cabanas, the teachers of Colt Cabana and CM Punk, Danny Dominion, and Ace Steel made their way to the IWA in the summer of 2000. And they all developed as a result of their experience and the ring time that the IWA Mid-South provided them with shows every week, held back then sometimes twice a week.
Yes, that is the key part here that people don't realize. I mean, a lot of people that buy our tapes, they're used to the East Coast where, you know, maybe once every 3 weeks, once a month, you know, if you're lucky, maybe once every 2 weeks. I mean, we're running here every week. You know, and as you said, sometimes twice a week. And that's why Chris Hero, CM Punk, that's why these guys have been able to get so much better, is because practice makes perfect, as we all know, Dave Prazak. And the more time you spend in the ring, the better you get. And we haven't even really touched on this, but 6 months ago, when CM Punk was out with a fractured skull, did you ever think that we would see a one-year anniversary of this matchup?
We weren't sure if CM Punk was going to ever be able to compete anywhere in professional wrestling at that point in time. Back in June, out in New Jersey, for the Jersey J Cup tournament against Reckless Youth, suffering a fractured skull, came back 3 months later to compete, and quickly, I'd say in phenomenal time, regained the heavyweight championship of the IWA. But yeah, when all these guys came to the IWA in the year 2000, Ian Rotten basically gave these kids a chance not only just to show what they could do in the IWA, but basically the statement was made that anytime you guys aren't booked anywhere else, be it in Milwaukee, St. Paul, Minnesota for Steel Domain Wrestling, which is where Punk and Cabana and Ace Steel and Danny Dominion spent a lot of time. If they weren't booked in Detroit or Chris Hero out in Ohio or Pittsburgh for Norm Connors, if they weren't booked anywhere else, every other weekend that they were available, they had a place to gain more experience and to learn and better their craft in an IWA ring. And they are extremely thankful, and they've said it many times, to the IWA management for that opportunity.
You know, hold on to your hat here, Dave Prazak, because I'm going to say something that you thought you'd never hear.
What's that, Jim?
I'm going to say something good about MAW.
What are you going to say about MAW?
It was, you know, credit has to go to them, because it was them, with CM Punk being a Chicago guy, it was through those shows that Ian Rotten was able to see the Colt Cabanas and the CM Punks to decide that they were worthy to be given a chance and to work out the rough edges.
That's true. Punk and Cabana got their Mid-American tryout in January of the year 2000 in West Dallas, Wisconsin. Punk earned a spot on the Mid-American roster for a few shows, but promoter Carmine Dispirito wasn't exactly so sure about the ability of CM Punk. He was very inexperienced at the time. Ian Rotten actually, at that point, started using CM Punk on more of a regular basis than Carmine was. And Chris Hero, at that point in time, looking to better himself, wanted to expand out of the state of Ohio in that general region, came to the IWA, and through referee Brent Blades and the Suicide Kid, was able to get booked in the IWA Mid-South, was given a match on a show out back in Charlestown, Indiana, against Harry Palmer, put in a strong showing, and earned a spot on the roster.
CM Punk, the second time was the charm instead of the third time for that big flying head scissors attempt, but I don't think Chris Hero's going to stay in this hole too long. He's already headstand his way out of an arm bar, so I think we might be able to see another one of those kind of maneuvers in order to get out of this hold right here. But then again, we're almost 30 minutes in. Maybe it's not such a bad idea for Chris Hero to lay here for a couple seconds, try to catch his wind, regroup himself, make a couple of strategy changes maybe, and decide how he wants to come back out of this hold and get after CM Punk.
He's not going to really be able to catch his wind if he's got CM Punk's legs wrapped right around his throat. That was basically a leg scissors down on the mat as Punk was trying to keep Hero from regaining the advantage, but he did it anyway.
Yeah, but
coming
Hero,
back up,
Hero
sunset flip position, near fall.
Hero was able to get his hand in there, get just a little bit of space, take a couple of breaths, and then he rocked his way out of that maneuver.
Back into the arm drag, and Punk holding onto the arm once again.
You know, here's where both of these men face a severe disadvantage, Dave Prazak. While they may be able to out-wrestle most of the other people on the roster that may not know them quite so well, these guys been in the ring so often against each other, they know what the other man's thinking. So when he's trying to go for the counter to the hold he's in, that man's countering the counter that's about to be attempted.
And that's why we see such long matches between these two. And once again, holding on to that leg scissors around the throat of Chris Hero. He did the flying head scissors and wouldn't let Hero's head go. You see so many flying head scissors in wrestling, and the guy just goes flying across the ring, sometimes all the way out to the floor, but Punk held on with his leg strength and still has Hero trapped down on the mat.
Here, squeezing the air. Now you can see Hero trying to get that hand in there, create just enough separation so that he's still able to breathe regularly while he's down there. And now he's
turned it around.
Quickly turned it into a head scissors of his own.
A reversal by Chris Hero, and now has CM Punk in the very position that he found himself in for the past several minutes.
30 minutes are gone. 60 minutes remaining in your time limit.
30 minutes have elapsed in the time limit. No falls as of yet. Now, we've talked a little bit about the background of CM Punk
hell?
And his training at the...
No!
At
no.
the Steel Domain Wrestling School in Chicago, Illinois. Chris Hero, on the other hand, began his training in Middletown, Ohio, wrestling a series of matches with Al Snow's half-brother Logan Kane, wrestling for such promotions as NWA East, NWA West Virginia and Ohio, UCW, the International Superstars of Professional Wrestling out in New Jersey, AFA, the Wild Samoans, WXW, learned a lot from Head Shrinker Samu, came across Matt Stryker on a show in Indiana and started training for a period of time with Les Thatcher in Ohio at his main event training center. And from there, he wanted to learn even more and decided to attend two of Dory Funk Jr.'s camps down in Ocala, Florida in December 1999 and February 2000. Earned a spot on the Insane Clown Posse's JCW tour through Madman Pondo in early 2000. And from then, was able to work his way into the IWA Mid-South. And again, that was through referee Brent Blades and Suicide Kid putting in a word. I remember Chris Hero walking into the locker room of the old Charlestown building and making a comment, you know, Ian, I'd really like the opportunity to wrestle here. And Ian asked a few guys in the locker room, you know, do you know anything about this kid? I've never seen him wrestle. And as soon as he heard that he was trained by Dory Funk Jr., he said, okay, I'll give you a shot next week, Chris.
That was the show that Mitch Page got injured at, was it not?
May have been.
I think that was the night that Chris Hero came down looking for a job was the night that Mitch got hurt.
And in the time after that, not only wrestling in the IWA and across the independent scene, but Chris Hero has been on three trips to Europe and has a fourth coming up February 21st through March the 9th. So, you know, when we say worldwide, we actually mean it in the case of someone like Chris Hero, who does not only compete on independent shows in the United States and isn't only wrestling in front of a couple hundred people once a week in southern Indiana, just outside of Louisville, Kentucky.
Yo, Hero trying to overpower Punk down there. He's getting two counts. Does he have a short arm scissors on the?
It looks like he may, but Punk's trying to fight his way out of this with a couple kicks to the body and the arm of Chris Hero. But this time, Hero traps the leg of CM Punk as he's going for one of those kicks. Referee Rudy Charles in perfect position. Punk able to roll his body out of the predicament where his shoulders would be pinned down to the canvas. As the fans get behind these two guys.
We are almost 38 minutes. Yeah.
And Punk now hooked for what looks like it might be a fisherman suplex, but he maneuvers his way out of that position and lands a kick to the back of the head and the side of the head of Chris Hero, Enziguri style, and now going to work on the legs, now trapping Chris Hero down on the mat.
We're like 33, almost 34 minutes into this. We came to a realization.
This thing's gonna go a long fucking time.
Where's the cat for this?
Right now, CM Punk with control of Chris Hero. Is Punk in a standing position with Chris Hero back down on the mat? Punk dragging him now into another part of the ring, keeping him away from the ropes where Chris Hero could just reach back with his arm and force a break of this. Of this toe hold that CM Punk has. Borrowing a page out of Dory Funk Jr.'s book. And a rolling toe hold, but once again, Punk holding on to the original hold. Hero tried to use his leverage and his momentum to roll his way out of that, but Punk, relentless, able to hold on to it and keep the hold.
Let's go back into a couple more predictions here. Chase C. Bailey. He picked CM Punk to win in 62 minutes. And I think that was the shortest amount of time
that
anyone...
That
was the shortest amount of time that anyone predicted. The last set that we went through, everyone had it in like the 85, 86, 87, you know.
Ankle lock applied now by Chris Hero. Punk grabs a hold of Chris Hero's hair possibly in a little bit of desperation, he does not want to give up a fall to Chris Hero, because that just means one more pinfall, and not only does he lose this match on the one-year anniversary of their most historic matchup of the series, but he loses the IWA Heavyweight Championship.
35 minutes, are gone. 35 minutes.
We had the prediction from the Spider Nate Webb. He went with Chris Hero in a time, again, very close to the 90-minute time limit of 89 minutes and 47 seconds. But he picked Hero to finally pull it off and win the title from Punk.
You know, it was a great series of matches that Nate Webb had with Chris Hero, perhaps the best matches that he's had in IWA. Nate Webb.
Yes.
For the... They had, a 30-minute Iron Man match that Nate Webb won in sudden death, establishing himself here in the IWA to our fans as a legitimate wrestler and hardcore guy.
Hardcore wrestler, and just on the 301st show, J.C. Bailey doing basically the same thing. He's known for the hardcore wrestling, but wants to show he can wrestle as well. Had a tremendous match with Chris Hero on that 301st show. And a lot of the young guys... that came into the IWA in the year 2000, learned from the veterans of the IWA rings at that time. And right now, the J.C. Baileys of the world and the Nate Webbs of the world are learning from wrestling people like CM Punk and Chris Hero. So, you know, it all comes around. Belly to back, suplex, but Punk lands on his feet. Stomped down right down onto the face of Chris Hero.
He may have broke Hero's jaw with that one.
I was worried that Punk had come down on his head there, but he was able to rotate just enough to land on his feet on that belly-to-back suplex.
Well, here's a double-edged sword of that one. Not only could he have broke Hero's jaw with that, he could have broke his ankle. Ankle bent.
And Chris Hero, didn't he suffer a broken nose just a few weeks ago?
In that matchup with J.C.
Bailey,
Hero broke his nose.
And now we're getting serious. Exchanging chops back and forth, and Chris Hero delivering a beautiful forearm, clubbing forearm across the back now. And you can hear those forearms connect in the back of this building.
I think Dylan Knight just shit himself, and he's not even in the ring with Hero anymore.
Punk with Hero backed into the corner, and now chops in the corner, and now he's getting a little serious. We saw the exchange of holds. We saw them holding on to knuckle locks and arm bars, and right now it's just coming down to forearms, chops, and punches. And right now CM Punk trying to suplex the larger man, Chris Hero. Hero blocking the maneuver, several shots to Chris Hero. Can Punk get the suplex? He does. Floats over with it, only a two count. Chris Hero able to kick out, and Punk holds on to a rear chin lock to the delight of these fans.
You know, Punk, he knows that time is on his side. He does not have to defeat Chris Hero. He just has to last the time limit. But at some
point... Did you hear that kick? Right square in the back. Final tap, Chris Hero. In a second.
But that does not mean that CM Punk is going to tank it. Doesn't mean he's going to put it in the deep freeze. He's going to go all out because he wants to prove once and for all that he is better than Chris Hero.
Handful of hair by CM Punk slowly pulling the body of Chris Hero up, but Hero getting a little fire. Lands a forearm, snap there, and a kick to the back of CM Punk. There's a little receipt for him.
I think that's a case of anything you can do, I can do better, which happens to be the name of one of the IWA videotapes. Of course, that was Necro Butcher and Mean Mitch Page going at it. And how great was it to have the return of Mean Mitch Page, a man who both of us have managed in the past here tonight.
Coming up with a victory in his return matchup tonight. Right now, and we saw this happen, for those of you who were here or saw the videotape of the 1 hour draw between these two. At one point, Chris Hero, just trying to last a little bit more time, stayed down on the ground and tried to scurry away from CM Punk and take his legs out from him, and he just did right there. Now holding on to the ankle.
He wasn't that successful in the 60-minute draw of
it.
But it worked much better, so he must have been putting in some training time with that. Or perhaps
Amos clutch, cinched in, but way too close to the ropes.
And Punk wasted no time. As I brought up earlier in the broadcast with, I believe it was Drake Younger, he was that close to the ropes, but he stayed in the move for like 45 seconds, not realizing where he was. CM Punk knows where he's at every second that he is in that ring, and he knew to just reach up, grab that rope, and that holds no more.
The first time these two squared off in a singles contest in the IWA. We have a time announcement here, Jim. Coming up.
40 minutes are gone. 40 minutes.
They go for a lockup, but Punk grabs hold of the leg, takes Hero down, and once again, trapping the legs of Chris Hero, and he can't move around in that position.
Is that like a modified Indian deathlock of sorts?
Of sorts. It's almost like it got him, his leg kind of trapped, similar to a figure four. But Hero trying to fight his way out of this predicament.
Well, the leg's bent down a little too much for that, but...
Rudy Charles seeing if Hero, if too much pressure is put on that leg, we could see submissions here.
Now that we've reached 40 minutes, let's look at a couple more predictions here. I was able to catch Dean Baldwin and Shark Boy in the back. They didn't quite see eye to eye on this matchup. Shark Boy went with Chris Hero winning in 84 minutes. But Dean Baldwin picked CM Punk to go over in 69 minutes.
Okay, well, I'm not going to pick a winner in this. Are you picking a winner in this, Jim?
I mean, I don't think it'd be fair for us to pick a winner. I mean, we've watched 40 minutes of the match so far to get an idea where we thought it was going.
But it has been pretty back and forth.
I don't think either man has had control of the other for more than 2-3 minutes at a time.
That's true. Chris Hero trying to fight his way out of this leg submission predicament that CM Punk has trapped him in. Can't quite completely break free of it just yet. The first time these guys faced each other in a singles match in the IWA was simply the best one, which was the same card that had Suicide Kid taking on Jerry Lynn.
Phenomenal matchup.
It was February the 17th, 2001. The winner of that match was CM Punk with the top rope pedigree, the Pepsi Plunge on Chris Hero.
Which is a fate that Chris Hero has met far too often in this series of matchups, Dave Prazak. And, you know, we sit up here and we have a good idea what these two gentlemen are all about because both of us have managed both of these individuals. And
we're seeing sportsmanship right now. I mean, because Punk was able to maneuver his way out of the hold. Hero was also able to save his legs. And both of them, again, it's a stalemate. We're 40 minutes in.
43
Jim,
minutes.
It's a stalemate.
43 minutes in. And like we just said, neither man has held an advantage. What is. We are zooming in on an injury to Chris Hero. Something with his hand. What was Chris Hero showing? The people at home will be able to see it. We may be up in the spider's nest up here, but doesn't mean that we can really see everything that's going on.
Punk looks to be looking for a Greco-Roman knuckle lock again, which might be a good idea if there's something wrong with Chris Hero's his hand or his wrist. Hero a little bit hesitant to lock up with him. Can't say I blame him if he is injured. Kind of a backwards Greco-Roman knuckle lock. With opposite arms. And now Hero maneuvers that into a perfect predicament. Choking CM Punk with his very own arms.
You know, there's nothing that Rudy Charles can do to stop that maneuver. You know, he's still not quite used to the IWA lack of rules, if you will.
As we have come to learn, it is all up to the referee's discretion. I mean, if they want to enforce a few rules, they can.
Yes,
they're just a little bit more lenient with the rules down here than they are in other places in professional wrestling.
He was asking me, you know, what do I do if someone goes for a chair? It's like, get out of the way so you don't get hit with it. You know, he's like, I can't DQ him. I'm like, you can DQ him, but I don't think you're going to make it out of the building alive.
Arm ringer by Chris Hero grabs onto the other wrist of Punk and once again has him choking with his own arm.
You know, and if you notice, both arms of CM Punk right across the carotid artery.
And now just stretching him. Stretching his back across the knees of Chris Hero while pulling back on Punk's own hands.
But as you can see, there's a little bit of daylight there on the throat. You know, while it's a lot worse for the back and the legs of CM Punk, at least he doesn't have to worry about getting, being, you know, passing out from having the blood I mean, he's still upside down a little bit, so he's still got to worry about that. But
fans here are encouraging CM Punk to hang in there and not give it up. We could have a first bout with a submission right here, but Punk maneuvers his way out of the predicament and has Hero now trapped in the very same hole.
35 minutes are gone. We are halfway through the time limit.
Knee right to the middle of the back of Chris Hero while holding on to the knuckle lock and choking out Chris Hero with his own arms. In May of 2001, the next time they were involved in the same matchup, it was the team of Chris Hero and BJ Whitmer taking on the team of CM Punk and Mark Wolfe in a tag team match in Charlestown. The winner of that match was the team of Mark and CM Punk as Punk scored the pinfall over Chris Hero.
Gets a little bit of payback for that tag match victory from the first time.
Forearm right to the jaw of Hero by Punk. Measures him for a second. Third time's the charm. This time he spins around. Just backhands him.
Forearm. He does it again.
At the roaring Stossel. Just slaps him right across the face, basically.
Not only will Chris Hero lose about 10 pounds from just this match, the soft food diet he'll be on for the next couple of days after that cause him to lose a couple more.
And Punk to his feet, and Hero looks to be out on, you know, face first on the mat.
But maybe this is a mistake by CM Punk. Perhaps he should have went for a cover there, Dave prays at, because I think he knocked Hero loopy there for a couple of seconds. He may have been able to get a pinfall there if he'd hooked the tights.
He's focusing on a body part right now. The right leg of Chris Hero is the victim of several stomps. Now the midsection, back to the leg.
You know, we touched on the injury to CM Punk.
Well, boot scrapes right across the face of Hero, too. Third time, gets a running start, and he just kicks his face into the front row.
Smart Mark video. Kind of close up.
It was close. We almost had 1-0 CM Punk right there. But Hero able to get the right shoulder up right before Rudy Charles hit the mat for a third time.
But as I was about to say, Dave Prazak, before CM Punk turned it up a few notches there, CM Punk pre-fractured skull would have been pulling a couple of shortcuts, may have been hooking a couple of tights, may have been able to gain a pinfall at some point in this matchup using those tactics.
Oh, that lariat rocked Hero but didn't knock him down. Second one doesn't do the trick. Third time, ducked by Hero, but he knocks him down with a charging clothesline. And again, an earfall for CM Punk. And Punk has had the match in his favor for about the past 3 minutes or so, with all the boots in the corner, working on the leg of Hero, and now the series of clotheslines.
We are almost 50 minutes in, Dave Prazak, and they're still going strong.
And Hero's still going strong, comes back with a clothesline of his own, and Punk now, he might have knocked his jaw a little bit loose on that one.
I know you hate me always mentioning this, Dave Prazak, but our matchup from Hardcore Hell and Back, we would have had to have wrestled
compared to this.
We would have had to have wrestled 16 times already.
Punk out to the floor. To the floor, and it looks like Hero might be looking for a dive. 50 minutes in almost. Tornado dive to the floor.
And you know, one of these signature maneuvers from the matchup that we're celebrating here tonight
was right there.
Russian leg sweep off the balcony.
Yo,
9 feet down.
Bring it up that we're in the spider's nest here. And
no. I'm just talking about Hero hit the concrete pretty hard right there on that dive.
Yes, he did. Well, so did CM Punk when he connected with
him. He hit hard on that dive, and it just made me flash back to that matchup that we're here to celebrate when I can remember screaming down from there to stop the match. I thought both men were dead after that Russian leg sweep. Yeah. We heard Hero's head smack the concrete, and they continued on.
We saw Punk taking the initiative a little bit earlier on, resorting to the forearms and the punches and the kicks. Now we see Hero taking a few risks with the dive to the floor, and now Punk with a Russian leg sweep and a float over, but only gets a near fall. Both men finally willing, almost an hour into it, not quite just yet, starting to take a few risks, starting to get a little bit more aggressive with their opponent. We don't even have one fall yet. Punk hooking Hero now for a suplex, taking his time right in the center of the ring. Vertical suplex down to the canvas goes the body of Chris Hero. 50
minutes are gone. 50 minutes.
40 remain in the time limit. June 23rd, 2001, CM Punk defeated Richard X in the opener of that IWA card. Eventually turned on Colt Cabana and the Gold Bond Mafia later in the show. Wound up being Chris Hero's mystery partner in a tag team match later that night against Tarik the Great and the Suicide Kid, forming an alliance between these two in the IWA back in the summer of 2001, an alliance which eventually became known as the Superhero.
That it was, Dave Prazak. It united these two, it united us.
Along with BJ Whitmer and the rugby thug Trent Baker at their side. Duck of the clothesline by Chris Hero, duck of the elbow, and a big boot just knocks CM Punk right out of his boot.
Of course, that led to the phenomenal eight-man tag elimination match.
There was actually first a six-man tag at Extreme Heaven where it was, well, first of all, just repeated kicks to the face of CM Punk. That could be a pinfall, but no, Punk able to kick out. Hero getting a little serious now. It was Punk and Hero teaming with BJ Whitmer against the Suicide Kid, Colt Cabana, and Tarik the Great in an elimination-style matchup. Which saw Chris Hero as the sole survivor in that matchup. That was in July of 2001. Non-IWA show in July. They were again a team with the Suicide Kid that time, putting some differences aside for the Crossroads Wrestling Alliance at X-Fest in Indianapolis, defeating the American Kickboxer Ace Steel and Colt Cabana. And then we did have that eight-man elimination tag match which went damn close to an hour. Hardcore Hell and Back. Well,
here's the thing, Dave Prazak. As you mentioned, they teamed in that matchup with the Suicide Kid. Differences in the IWA often get put aside when you go elsewhere because there's the bond.
Two.
As the t-shirt used to say, we are family here.
That's right.
And while we may have differences while we're here in the IWA, we take pride in being a part of this family. So when we go elsewhere, we can put differences aside, team up, take on those local people from the federation that we are in at that point in time. Show them why here in the IWA Mid-South, we think that we are the best wrestlers.
Jackie Chan out of the corner, Punk lands on his feet, boot to the midsection of Chris Hero, wheelbarrow, trying to reach back, gets the bulldog on Chris Hero. Just before that, you saw Hero with the advantage, was going for the cravat suplex. Punk wiggled his way out of the predicament. Hero eventually was able to get a German suplex, dropping Punk on his head, but he came right back. And as Hero was trying to pull Punk out of the corner, the Jackie Chan, Punk tried to gain the advantage, only got a near fall on Chris Hero still. No advantage for either man. We have no pinfalls or submissions thus far in this 2 out of 3 falls, 90-minute time limit.
Is he going for the double underhook backbreaker?
Double underhook backbreaker. Can't get Chris Hero.
What is it? Welcome to Chicago.
Motherfucker. Chris Hero lifts CM Punk up on his back as he's trying to go for the double underhook. Can't keep him up. Double underhook backbreaker. He gets all of it. Takes a lot out of the back of Chris Hero, but takes a lot out of the back of CM Punk. Goes for the Shining Wizard. It looks like Hero ducked it.
Oh, but that
spins around and kicks him in the head. Anyway, 1, 2, 3. CM Punk scores the first pinfall.
First pinfall. 53 minutes, 56 seconds. CM Punk. He now leads 1-0.
53-56, CM Punk. Looking for the Shining Wizard. Hero able to duck the knee of CM Punk after he stepped up onto Chris Hero's leg. Punk with the ability to spin around and still land a kick to the side of the head of Chris Hero scores the pinfall. It's 1-0 in favor of your heavyweight champion.
A little bit of water for Chris Hero. Hell, we need water up here, and all we're doing is watching and talking.
Punk with a handful of Chris Hero's hair. only needs one more pinfall, and the victory is his. He retains the title, and his work is done for one night. And then he goes across this country to New York tomorrow night for Ring of Honor.
Now the odds are really stacked against Chris Hero.
Chops, forearms, and chops from Chris Hero right back at him.
55 minutes are gone.
Double chops. Listen to those blows land. Hard hitting wrestling right here in the IWA Mid-South.
I think suffering that pinfall put new life into Chris Hero. But as I was about to say before I announced the 55-minute mark, the odds are almost insurmountable now against Chris Hero. Not only does he have time going against him, he now needs to defeat CM Punk by pinning him twice in a row. And he only has two pinfalls in 2.5 years.
Hero loses the hold of CM Punk's head, and the pressure he's trying to put across his neck now cross faces by CM Punk right across Chris Hero's grill.
This is gut check time, Dave Prazak.
This Rudy is Charles check. Getting in there. Will Chris Hero give it up? We could have a winner right here.
Wasn't that what CM Punk used to defeat him in the Ted Petty?
At the Ted Petty Invitational.
Crossface chicken wing.
In the semifinals of that tournament. Crossface chicken wing. The fans encouraging Chris Hero to hang in there. If Hero gives it up here, the match is over. Just under an hour in
time. He's crawling his way over. He gets to the ropes.
And Rudy Charles puts the count on CM Punk. He waits till the very last second to release that hold. Take a little bit more out of Chris Hero.
There'll be no more water breaks after that for Chris Hero. He's got to get back up, get to his feet, and he's got to dig deep. He's got to find some reserve somewhere in order to keep going.
Shoulder block.
And anything he had, CM Punk just took away from him there. Battering ram. Right
top rope. CM Punk goes. Cross body. But Hero catches him. That battering ram didn't do very much to Chris Hero's midsection, apparently.
Swinging Fish Hero. Around.
Hero sandwich into a back breaker across the knee. Two.
Into the ropes.
Barely getting his toes on the middle rope of the IWA ring.
Chris Hero was that close to tying this up, Dave Prazak.
That's ring positioning, and CM Punk knew where he was at. His foot barely reached that rope.
That has to be demoralizing, Dave Prazak. Has to be.
Hero pulls him into the middle of the ring. Sullivan stomp down onto the chest of CM Punk. Almost an hour into this matchup. Drops the full body weight.
Back senton in.
This has got to be. Leg two. Punk kicks out.
What does Chris Hero have to do in order to get a pinfall over CM Punk?
He has yet to bust out the Hero's welcome. He has yet to actually hit the cravat suplex. He has yet to get the hangman's clutch in the middle of the ring.
But Dave, he just sent 240 pounds of velocity, 2 feet, stomping into the gut of CM Punk. Had to knock everything out of Punk.
And he's waiting. He's measuring him right now, waiting for Punk to get back to his feet. Hits the ropes. Ducks under, CM Punk does. Holds onto the neck. Neck breaker into a back breaker across the knee. Punk hits the ropes. Comes charging. Collides with the shoulder of Hero. Hits a lariat. Doesn't knock the big man down. Comes with another, and this time he takes Punk down. His own momentum knocked him down right there, and still able to kick out. Punk's still able to kick out. Still 1-0 CM Punk.
I don't know even if he hits the Hero's welcome, if it's going to be enough. I don't know. Where does CM Punk get it?
It's fighting spirit that these two have down deep.
Dave Prazak, we are 1 minute away,
from
being an hour into this.
And once again, we go back to what we were doing at the beginning of this match. Holds down on the canvas, looking for submissions, trying to wear each other down. Can he make Chris Hero submit right here?
And before I call out 1 hour, Ian Rotten picks CM Punk in 65 minutes. 65 minutes is the guess from Ian Rotten for CM Punk. He's got 5 minutes to pin Chris Hero or make him say I quit to fulfill that prediction. Is there anybody? I really don't see anybody else other than J.C. Bailey has Punk winning in 62.
Punk trying to hold on to this leg hold on Chris Hero while he's trying to fight his way out of it. Reaches the bottom rope.
One, two, three.
And he breaks the hold at the count of three of referee Rudy Charles.
I think Hero needs to get a pinfall in the next couple of minutes to have a chance at this, Dave. He needs to have plenty of time to work with.
Hardcore Hell and Back, these two were involved in an eight-man elimination tag with Too Cold Scorpio, Ian Rotten, and all those guys that were involved in the six-man elimination. 30 minutes are left in the time limit. They teamed again for the Independent Wrestling Revolution in Detroit at St. Andrews Hall, August 25th, 2001, to defeat Colt Cabana and Ace Steel. Keeping their alliance throughout the summer of 2001, both in the IWA and elsewhere in professional wrestling, across the Midwest independent scene. Right now, Punk looking for a suplex, but Hero uses his weight and his leverage to block it, tries to soften him up a little bit to get the suit. Can he? No.
Did we really go into in-depth conversation on that eight-man tag elimination? Did we even mention who was involved in that one?
It was, we got to focus on this. Front flip neck breaker by Chris Hero. Hooks the leg. Near fall.
I was picking up the microphone, Dave Prazak. I was ready to announce that Chris Hero had tied this thing up.
Front flip leg drop, one of the specialties of Chris Hero. Bust that out every once in a while. Doesn't do the trick to get the second fall of this 2 out of 3 falls contest here tonight, February 7th, 2003. That eight-man elimination tag, it was Too Cold Scorpio teaming with Ian Rotten, the Suicide Kid, and Colt Cabana against Ace Steel, Danny Dominion, CM Punk, and Chris Hero.
And that matchup, it went like 55
minutes, 56
minutes,
something
like
that.
And that was in like 104 degree heat in that building.
The survivors of that match were Ian Rotten and Too Cold Scorpio. That was Hardcore Hell and Back 2001, available on Smart Mark and IWA Home Video. Trying to get the cravat from this position cinched in. Chris Hero loves that three-quarter chancery. Ever since coming back from the Blue Bloods training camp that he attended along with CM Punk in October 2002, where they learned some of the finer points of submission wrestling from guys like Dave Taylor, Fit Finley, and William Regal.
Also, Sexy Ace Steel was along for that one, which goes into what I said like an hour ago about how you never stop learning. Sexy Ace Steel, been in this business for a long time. Well, trained people like the Punk and Colt Cabana, and he's still going to camps to learn how to get better.
Rolling back, having CM Punk in a pinfall predicament, but Punk keeps rolling, and right into the three-quarter chancery. Will Punk give it up right here? Will he tap out? It's 1-0 Punk. If you give it up here and still hold on to the title, it'll be tied 1-1 if Punk gives it up right here. Three-quarter chancery by Hero. Modified Hangman's has the cravat. Punk nowhere near the ropes. Hero has his body, his legs wrapped around the body of CM Punk right now. Checks the arm. Rudy Charles does one. It falls a second time, third time, and we're tied 1-1. No.
The arm dropped, but the other hand came up.
He held it up and up.
JC Bailey's prediction has been passed. We're past 62 minutes.
JC Bailey.
We're nearing Ian Rotten's. And then everybody else is like 75 minutes, and then on up from that. I mean, these men know how much, the guys in the back knew how much spirit both of these competitors had coming into this matchup.
Shelley predicted 91.
I looked 90, at this. 91.
91. I guess he's thinking of an overtime or something.
It'd be a quick overtime, wouldn't it?
As these fans encourage these guys,
maybe he
keep at it.
Maybe he thinks it'll be like the 60-minute draw when somehow I lost track of time for 40 seconds, and it ended up being 60 minutes and 40 seconds.
Stomps down onto the upper chest of CM Punk in the corner, pulls him in the middle of the ring. Looks like he might be going for the Hero's Welcome right here. Superhero heads it.
That's got to be it.
Hooks the leg. 1, 2.
No!
Punk kicks out. We remain 1-1.
How does he do it? And I told you 10 minutes ago, if everything that Hero has done to Punk hasn't worked yet, the Hero's Welcome may not even work, and it didn't.
Now, that's the luxury of someone like Chris Hero learning so many things, studying so many tapes. He's got like five or six finishers he uses. He's got the Hangman's Clutch, the Hero's Welcome, the Hero Sandwich.
The Kvat Suplex.
The Kvat Suplex.
The man could do anything.
He could bust out anything that he really wanted to. And right now he's got CM Punk shot into the buckle. Punk takes it, gets his boot up right into the mush of Chris Hero, who staggers back into Punk, wraps his legs around, kicking down onto the top of the head of Chris Hero. Trying to free himself of that top rope. Into a flying head scissors by CM Punk. Takes the big man over.
We are almost 65 minutes in.
And both of these men are so tired. Hero, as a result of that, rolls all the way to the concrete floor.
65 minutes.
Rudy Charles puts a count on Chris Hero. If we have a count out here, which we don't see too often in the IWA, but again, everything's up to the discretion of the referee. If we have a count out here, then he loses the match. CM Punk retains the title.
He may have mercy for Hero if Hero can't get back in there. I mean,
does Punk want a count out?
No.
Fall there's
no
here, though?
There is no,
no
way.
He's making his way out of that ring. He's going to break up that count.
There is no way that CM Punk wants to win on a count out after 65 minutes. There's no way.
Punk on the apron. Flying head scissors on the concrete floor into the front row. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Going back into the history once again. Following our train right after Hardcore Hell and Back, after the Bump and Uglies show. September 15th, 2001. Hero was scheduled to take on the Road Dog. Punk challenged Hero, even though they're both in the superheroes, to a match.
And
went
that's,
to a double pin.
And that's where the animosity began. They both wanted to overtake the rugby thug. The competitive spirit. Both of them wanted to be champions.
Sweet. No. Several forearms by CM Punk gets back in the ring. Sails through the ropes and lands a flying forearm through the top and the middle to the floor. Lands himself
in the 30
rows deep and knocks Chris Hero in the next week.
This has been a phenomenal matchup, Dave Prazak. This has lived up to the hype. This has lived up to everything I thought
only,
it was going to be.
We're only one fall in.
And we're only one fall in. There's still potentially two falls to go, at least one more.
Hero scheduled to take on the Road Dog. Road Dog wound up not being able to compete.
That, of course, was after the tragic events of New York City.
Of 9/11.
Airports were shut down. He was not able to catch a flight.
It was between Punk and Hero who got the shot at Rugby Thug. They went to a double pin, and Hero said, "You're the better man," thinking they'd shake hands, everything would be all nice and well and dandy in IWA land. But Punk's like, "Okay, fine, I'll take the title shot."
Yeah, and like I said, that began the animosity, and it was Chris Hero who was able to capture the title from the Rugby Thug. He defeated CM Punk to that. But that's like the only thing he's defeated. He's beat CM Punk.
Battling on the turnbuckles right now. Hero sitting on the top rope. Punk standing on the second turnbuckle, exchanging forearms, slaps across the back. CM Punk possibly looking for that reverse pile driver that they busted out so many times in Indianapolis, in Charlestown, Indiana. Could they do it here? Can he pull it off?
Can Hero pull off the top rope powerbomb he hit?
Can Hero block it?
Hell, Hero can.
Hero has
a Is he going for the Pepsi?
Is he going for the Tiger Driver he hit in Indianapolis in January? Pepsi Punch is our finisher. Three count. We're tied. We're tied.
Is the winner on the second floor in 68 minutes and
16 seconds. With CM Punk's own finishing ball.
One fall apiece. The third and deciding fall starts now.
IWC Pittsburgh, Hero pinned Punk. Not in an IWA ring. IWC, Hero pinned Punk in a tag match involving them as well as Q for the Flying Hawaiian and Colt Cabana. October 6, 2001, Hero got in the way of a fireball bullpen aimed at Patty, Ian Rotten's wife. Hero took the fireball, had to wrestle CM Punk later in the show, passed out from the blood loss in that match, lost the match to CM Punk, continuing their war. Right now, going for another pinfall right here. Had to try it. He had to try for it.
He had to, but everything I said earlier about Hero being at a huge disadvantage, that's all wiped out. He was able to climb that mountain, get that elusive pinfall, and as you know, once the first one comes, that second one becomes a whole lot easier.
November the 9th, Indianapolis FXW. It was a four-way dance. Hero pins CM Punk again, not in an IWA ring. He looks like he's going for that cravat plex. He connects. Cravat suplex. Could this be it? Could we see Chris Hero finally score a pinfall victory on CM Punk in the IWA? He kicks out. He scored a pinfall, but he hasn't gotten a victory in a match, in a singles match.
Listen to this, Dave Prazak.
70 minutes are gone.
20 remain.
This is
he scored pinfalls on CM Punk in the past in the IWA. Again, they had a 2 out of 3 falls match in January in Indianapolis in the year 2002. He scored a fall over Punk in that match, but he was not able to win the match. Punk got the second fall, and that was with a Russian leg sweep. With the title belt held over the face of Chris Hero, that he scored that deciding
fall. Is that a little bit of payback for Hero?
Yeah, the boot scrapes across the face of CM Punk. Drags him into the middle of the ring, puts all of his body weight on him, but Punk's still able to kick out.
But that takes every ounce of strength and energy that CM Punk has to kick that 240 pounds off of him, and we're 70 minutes into this matchup.
Now going back to the legs, once again, Chris Hero is looking for a submission, looking to wear down CM Punk. It was December the 5th, 2001, our debut event at the Lyndhurst Drive Knights of Columbus in Indianapolis. It was CM Punk winning the heavyweight championship from Chris Hero in the match that featured the debut of Hero's valet, Nadia Nice. It was the Pepsi plunge that put away Chris Hero on December the 5th. And right now it's a slap fest. Yeah, they played by the rules for the first, I don't know, half hour of the match, but now it's just coming down to slaps across the face. Who is going to be the better man? We're tied. One fall apiece. Next fall wins this match. And dare I say, wins this feud. And there might not be so much animosity, but it's still a feud. There's still a rivalry between these two. Whether it's athleticism or hatred, they want to know who's the better man.
Both men taking a breather here, and I'd be dead right now. I'd have been dead 50 minutes ago. This is unbelievable that these two men still have so much determination, desire to defeat the other man, prove that they are
incredible,
the better man, that they're in here. We're 72 minutes in. 72 minutes in, and they're still fighting tooth and nail.
Hero picks CM Punk back up, hooks him, possibly looking for the Tiger Suplex, but using his leverage to crouch down, CM Punk trying to block an attempted suplex by Chris Hero. Going for that Tiger Suplex again, puts his leg behind the leg of Chris Hero's, trying to block it, turns it into an arm drag, taking Hero over. Shining Wizard connects right to the side of the headline. Two! That was 2 and 99 hundredths, Jim.
That finished off Chris Hero for the first fall. But the title's on the line. Everything is on the line now. If you get your shoulders pinned to the mat now, it's all over with. There's not another fall to make up here.
Punk asking for these fans to get behind him. I think they're behind both of these competitors. Punk launched, second turnbuckle, into a blockbuster. 1, 2, only two.
I think that was closer than the...
And that was the maneuver against Reckless Youth back in June of last year that Punk fractured his skull on. High-risk maneuvers, busting it all out. Hard-hitting wrestling right here tonight to see who deserves to wear the IWA's top prize around their waist.
Can we cut the belt in half and give it to both of them?
No, we can't.
Can we have co-champions so these men don't kill each other?
Nope. They just got to keep doing this shit to one another time and time again, and they love it. And so do these fans, exchanging forearms in the center of the ring. They've gone over an hour. They're at a stalemate once again, Jim.
Yeah, it's right back to the way the match began. Move after move, back and forth. Neither man with advantage. We're tied 1-1.
And they're rocking each other with each blow, but not knocking each other down until they just collapse. right there.
How either man is still standing at this point is beyond me, Dave Prazak.
It was 3 days after Punk's title win in Indianapolis, December the 8th, 2001, Christmas Carnage, three-way dance. These two and Colt Cabana, CM Punk retained the title by pinning Colt Cabana after hitting a Pepsi plunge on Chris Hero on top of the body of Cabana, and then chose to pin Cabana to retain the title. Just a month later in Indianapolis, the 2 out of 3 falls match. As I said, Punk won that. November the 11th, no gimmicks needed in Indianapolis as Punk won with the Russian leg sweep with the heavyweight title over the face of Chris Hero. A month later in Indianapolis, gauntlet match. Punk went through Colt Cabana, Ace Steel, and Chris Hero. Wrestled for 45 minutes. 1, 2. Punk kicks out. They wrestled for 45 minutes. Hero was the last person in that gauntlet match to face CM Punk. And just as the time limit expired, Chris Hero hit the Hero's welcome and couldn't get the pinfall he was looking for so badly. The very next night, Charlestown, Indiana, February the 9th, 2002. Tables and ladders, 55 minutes. Chris Hero loses to CM Punk in what was at the time his final bid for the heavyweight championship.
That's right.
They didn't face each other again in a singles matchup in an IWA ring until the Ted Petty Invitational. They took on each other in three-way dances against
one time.
Colt Cabana was in a three-way dance with them in Indianapolis in May the 3rd of 2002. Punk pinned Hero in that matchup. There was also a three-way dance at the Retro Night Show on October the 4th involving these two and BJ Whitmer, which saw B.J. Whitmer at the time retain his championship belt. Actually, no. Did B.J. have the title at that time?
No, B.J. won it. B.J. won it. I think Hero had the title.
It was on Hero.
Hero had it.
Hero hit Dislocator from up top. A Punk kicks out.
This is unbelievable, Dave Prazak.
He couldn't do it even dislocating his hip. What's he gonna have to do? Oh yeah, okay. We lose a little bit of track of who had the title. It was
Hero
who held
point.
The title at that point. He lost it the next night to M-Dog 20.
Then CM Punk defeated M-Dog 20, BJ Whitmer, by winning the Ted Petty Invitational, defeating CM Punk in the final. Punk, a fighting champion, defending the title all
throughout
the tournament.
Once we get the cravat, the three-quarter chancery, cinched in by Chris Hero.
But BJ won that match and subsequently the title. Then CM Punk regained the title from BJ Whitmer, which leads us to this point now. And
it was the Ted Petty Invitational semifinals. Punk beat him with the crossface chicken wing, made him submit. And after that, the last time that they wrestled one another, one-on-one, in the IWA Mid-South, December the 21st, 2002, a 60-minute time limit draw. Chris Hero held on to the hangman's clutch as the time limit expired. CM Punk wouldn't give it up, held on to the heavyweight champion.
It was a hell of a Christmas present for our fans that were in attendance. But Dave Prazak.
Shoulder tackle.
They have went.
Goes for the arm drag. Punk had him scouted. Hooks the leg. Two. Hero kicks out again.
They have went 18 minutes longer than their 60-minute draw.
That's right, and we don't have a
90% of wrestling matches don't even go 18 minutes, and they've went 18 minutes past an hour.
And in between their time wrestling each other in the year 2002 for this championship, they competed as tag team partners once again, along with Colt Cabana for Chikara Pro Wrestling out in Pennsylvania. Drop kick to the back of the head, springboard style.
I hope CM Hero Punk realizes how close he is to the ropes.
Very close to the ropes, and yep, knows where he's at. Excellent ring presence, grabs that bottom rope. Rudy Charles won't count to three.
Dave Prazak, do you realize that this match has now gone on longer than most movies these days?
It's true. It's very true.
You can come on out to the IWA, spend $10, watch one match.
Can people get in for eight tonight?
You can get in for $8, the price of what you can get into a movie. You get a match that goes as long as a movie, has more twists and turns than any movie you could ever watch. And you had all those other matches on the show.
Shoots Hero into the buckle, comes in. trying to go for another head scissors, but Hero hangs on. A couple shoulder blocks to the midsection of Chris Hero now.
Right about now, Chris Hero's wishing that he went over with that head scissors.
And again, fatigue starting to come into play right here as Punk drags the body of Chris Hero into the middle of the ring. Cinches in. Now, you see, Chris Hero does the Pepsi plunge on CM Punk to gain a victory. Now he's trying to do the very same thing, throw it right back in his face. Hangman's clutch cinched in by CM Punk, using Hero's own new favorite finishing hold on him to try to retain the heavyweight
title. Well, here's the difference, Dave Prazak. Chris Hero's going to have to stay in this hold for 11 minutes to make it to the time limit. CM Punk only had to stay in it for a minute.
How are we doing on time, Jim?
80 minutes are gone. 10 minutes remain in the time limit.
Punk's going for the Hero's welcome. He hits the Hero's welcome. 1, 2.
Hero kicks out.
Kicks out of his own finisher.
How did Chris Hero kick out of that?
Punk wasn't able to kick out of his finisher, but Hero was able to kick out of his. They also squared off in 2002 for IWC in the Super Indie Tournament. That was March 22nd, 2002. Punk, even on non-IWA turf, scored the victory with the Pepsi plunge.
Dave Prazak, I've noticed that you being the super-duper commentator that you are, you did some homework, and you hold in your hand some history.
Sleeper hold. First of all, sleeper hold cinched in by CM Punk right in the center of the ring. This could be it for Chris Hero, but yeah, I do hold some history. I knew this thing might go pretty long, so I did a little homework. This thing, as we approach the 90-minute time limit, other 90-minute draws. The last one I could track down, 1975 Dallas, Texas, Jack Briscoe versus Al Madrill, 90-minute draw. Jack Briscoe also went to a 90-minute draw against Dory Funk Jr., one of the trainers of Chris Hero, 1970 at the Gator Bowl in Jacksonville, Florida.
Yeah, but before you go on to any of the other ones, I can guarantee you that neither of those competitors in either of those matches did flipping dives over the top rope to the floor, dives three rows out into the crowd. None of them came flying off the top rope with the regularity that these men have. No Pepsi plunges in that matchup.
Where is Hero getting the strength? The sleeper hold has been cinched in by CM Punk in the center of the ring for almost a minute now, and he was able to make his way back to his feet with the help of these fans getting behind these guys. How many wrestling audiences would appreciate the athleticism of two guys wrestling for almost an hour and a half? Thank you to the IWA fans for appreciating.
Thank you to the IWA fans. Thank you to the CZW fans buying this on the East Coast, XPW fans, fans all over the country. Thank you for watching this videotape and seeing exactly what the best is that the IWA Mid-South has.
One, Rudy Charles checking the arm of Chris Hero. Oh, but he's still hanging in there. Only one.
Only a one. Chris Hero.
Other two 90-minute time limit draws. Harley Race and Dory Funk Jr. in Waterloo, Iowa. McElroy Auditorium, 1970. 2 out of 3 falls, much like this match. 90-minute draw. Chin breaker by Chris Hero.
And Punk
right
back on.
It right back on.
Punk
recovered
tenacious
from the chin breaker that quick that he was able to go back to the sleeper.
This is unbelievable, Dave Prazak.
And the fans still trying to give Chris Hero the encouragement to dig down deep and stay in the match. Stay the fight, Chris.
This is
Punk
unbelievable.
Trying to hold on. Lands on his feet.
Right back to it.
Once again, back to the sleeper hold. And again, in the center of the ring, Hero maybe trying to make his way down to the bottom rope. Rudy Charles checking on the condition of Chris Hero. Lou Thesz and Danny Hodge had wrestled to many 90-minute time limit draws. Bruno Sammartino versus Pedro Morales, 1973 at Shea Stadium, 90-minute draw. That was the first show that they did at Shea Stadium. The second one was Larry Zbysko involved in the matchup. We had Lorian.
We could be in. Oh, I was going to have to cut you off.
Was
his arm dropped.
Three?
His arm had dropped twice. We almost didn't get to be in 90-minute territory there.
But Punk trying to still hold on to this. But Hero digging down several shots to the midsection of CM Punk. Hero hits the rope back into the sleeper. Belly to back. Suplex.
Oh,
right on his head.
He landed on his to his feet.
He's on his feet, but he's got to
be out. He doesn't know where he's at. He's going to do it again. Bucks.
A second right on his head. Punk trying desperately to stay on his feet. Swings again. A third. Traps the leg this time. Right on his head. Felt him in half. Cover him. Cover him, Chris. Hooking the leg. Two.
No, his foot's on the bottom. He's in the ropes.
His foot is on the rope.
I thought that was it. Dave Prazak. It does not get any closer. It does not get closer than what that was right there.
Cyclone Negro and Lord Alfred Hayes went to a 90-minute draw, or so Alfred Hayes claimed at one of those Cauliflower Alley conventions when he said, yeah, he wrestled in 12 feet of snow.
Hold up a second.
1947 in front of 35,000 people in Bumblefuck, North Carolina. Do you want to believe him? I will. Him and Cyclone Negro can go the distance. CM Punk and Chris Hero going the distance.
Hero's welcome. He's going for it again.
A second.
Two of them.
Two heroes. Punk.
Two. No. These fans are going crazier than we are, Dave Prazak.
They kicked out. This is wrestling history, fans. The last 90-minute draw we were able to find anywhere, not just in the United States, the world, 1975.
Almost 30 years ago. We weren't even alive, Dave Prazak. We were not even alive the last time what is about to happen occurred.
Punk reverses it. It's a hero's welcome on Hero. Now he's rolling
with it. It's going right back to that. Anything you can do, I can do better.
Hooks the leg. Two.
Yo, people are sitting at home right now going, how is it that these men could be kicking out of each other's finishers? Ladies and gentlemen, you get in the ring, you wrestle 86 minutes, and you tell me how much you've got left on the moves that you're doing.
And listen to this crowd. Almost 90 minutes, and this crowd is on their feet, on fire, on the edge of their seats, waiting to see who will walk away from this building wearing the heavyweight championship.
I did these guys a disservice by not telling them when 4 minutes were left. I'm going to let them know when 3 minutes are left here in a couple of seconds.
Big boot by CM Punk. Both men staying on their feet. Boot by Punk has Hero rocked. Boot by Hero almost knocks down Punk. Forearm. Boot by Hero. Both on their feet. Hero hits the ropes. Running boot. Punk with a forearm. IWA.
The crowd standing on their feet, cheering for Hero, wanting the underdog to finally get the victory.
Spins with it.
Everybody is peeking out of the crowd. Everybody wants to know what's going to happen.
Both men are down.
2.5 minutes
away. He gets his shoulder up.
2.5. I'm up here bouncing, Dave Prazak. 2.5 minutes are left.
Hero not able to get the pinfall victory. 2 minutes remaining in a 90-minute time limit. 2 out of 3 false match on the anniversary weekend of one of the greatest matches in IWA history. This one is joining it in the history books.
This is unbelievable. I know I've said it, people. Bear with me at home. I know I've said this is unbelievable 900 times in this match already, but...
Somebody just said something about Bobby Eaton and Randy Savage going to a 90-minute draw for Nick Goulas in, like, 1978. I don't know about that. I'll believe Bobby Eaton, maybe.
Who knows? It wasn't able to be found.
But
that's
those men are still in this thing.
90 seconds remain.
Hero looking to finish the job. And he finally pins CM Punk to win the title. Punk blocks it. Kick. 3, 4, 5, 6. Around the world he goes. Now can Hero hook him? Or can Punk continue to
block? I can't even sit down, Dave.
Hook him, yeah.
I can't even sit down.
Going for the Hero's welcome. Can he get it? Lifts him up. Punk lands on his feet. State roll attempt. State roll to bridge.
Two.
That was a two count. It was two. Then both men's shoulders were down. Rudy Charles started to count a double pin at that point. Punk now climbing to the top rope. Harold meets him with a forearm across the back.
30 seconds,
and they're both on the top rope. What's Harold looking for here? Reverse power bomb off the top rope. That could be it. The title is Heroes right now. Right now. The title is Heroes.
1, 2, 3, 7.
He counted.
He's counting. 90 minutes have expired. Double pinfall.
Both shoulders were down.
2-2.
Both men were covering each other. Two falls. Just before the 90-minute time limit expired, a double pin at 8-9-57. Double pin with just seconds remaining before the expiration of
the guys are out of the back.
That's how you stand back there.
We're 90 minutes in, baby, and we still got another pinfall to go. This could go all night.
This is why
sudden death.
One of the most storied feuds in independent wrestling today. Chris Hero's a house of fire. Punk ducks the clothesline. Takes the leg out for Chris Hero. Shining Lizard connects.
That's three times.
Two. Hero kicks out.
That's the third time he's hit that, Dave. That's the third time. If a pinfall happens in the next 5 seconds, Alex Shelley was right.
Working over the leg of Chris Hero, drops it across his own knee. Dragon Screw leg whip by CM Punk, holds onto the leg. Spinning toe hold, trying to tie up Chris Hero. Down
Alex
on the mat.
Shelley wins on the Price is Right rule. Who's closest without going over?
The fans getting behind both of these guys. 50-50, split.
Listen to this crowd get into this.
Over an hour and a half of some of the most brutal, hard-hitting wrestling, high-flying, and technical wrestling you've ever seen. Here or anywhere.
Dave, I'm going down there because I can't split my time between this and everything
I'll
else.
I'll finish the job up here, Jim Fannin. CM Punk with Hero by the hair. Grabs hold of the arm. Working over that knee once again. Focusing on a body part like many of the old school wrestlers we mentioned before. Chris Hero has the Hangman's Clutch cinched in. He has the Hangman's Clutch cinched in. Can Punk stand the pain? Can he hang in there? Can he hang in there, dragging him away? Away from the ropes, into the center of the ring. Punk taps. Hero wins. Hero wins the new heavyweight champion of the world. They went 90 minutes to a double pin. Sudden death. Chris Hero stitches in the Hangman's Clutch. CM Punk taps out. And for the first time in IWA Mid-South history, in a singles match, Chris Hero, February 7th, 2003, has won the match. 2 out of 3 falls and defeated CM Punk in this ring. Three-time IWA heavyweight champion of the world, Chris Hero.
fans and all the wrestlers from the locker room have come out to congratulate these two athletes, these two warriors, for what they have put themselves through tonight. Over 90 minutes of action. On this night, Chris Hero is the better man.
Thank you, baby.
And there he displays proudly his newly won, his newly regained IWA Heavyweight Championship. That's what they fought over for over an hour and a half down here in Clarksville, Indiana. A handshake and an embrace in the center of the ring. They've said it before, they love nothing more than doing this to each other.
They say what these two did in the ring last year could not be topped. They proved each and every one said it wrong tonight. I'm just going to leave it this. Been here all night and everything else. Chris Hero, CM Punk, thank you. On the microphone, but tonight, Chris Hero has something he wants to say. I'm gonna keep it nice and short. This damn, I'm tired as hell. But everybody who bought a ticket tonight, everybody in this ring that wrestled for IWA tonight, Ian Rotten, CM Punk, Mark Wolf, thank you guys. Chris, I was going to put this belt around your waist, but I think there's somebody else that should do that.
Years of battling since they both came to the IWA in the year 2000, and finally something different happened. It wasn't the Pepsi plunge of CM Punk putting away Chris Hero.
Dude, don't bite me, please.
It was Chris Hero making CM Punk submit and earning the heavyweight title of the IWA Midsouth. Excellent show of class by CM Punk, putting the heavyweight title around the waist. The man who defeated him tonight.
Next week, you go to Philadelphia representing this company with XPW, and you tell them motherfuckers in Philly that it don't be a CZW deal. The time has come for Chris Hero to show them fuckers on the East Coast why we are the number one independent company. And you as our champ. You did it, Kim. You did it.
A tremendous display of wrestling ability, skill, heart, determination, call it what you want. It was one of the greatest matches ever held inside of this ring in the history of this promotion. Closing in on 7 years later on this year. Punk wants the mic.
I have nothing to say.
For once, CM Punk is speechless.
Here, yeah, Marine Punk doesn't have anything to say. I do. Make sure you come back and spend your money with us tomorrow night, too.
Phenomenal matchup. Jim, the official time. Fannin, what was the official time? Official time.
The official time was 92 minutes and 15 seconds.
92:15 for those playing along at home. No, Nate Webb, you didn't win.
Shelly won with the guys at 91 minutes.
We thank all of you for joining us on IWA and Smart Mark video. Please check us back once again, won't you? And visit IWAMidSouthWrestling.com.